Hey guys, Brian Holder here, Brian Holder Graphic Design. Got a user question here from Nick. Wants to know how I created the back to top button that I have on my site. So I think right now my website's down. I had some issues, and I do have one on this site. This is actually a WordPress site, but we can create something exactly like that. The only thing I'm not going to really be able to do today is figure out how to make it fade in and out as we scroll. That's going to be a JavaScript function. We could probably figure that out in time if we did a little bit of research, but for now I'm just going to show you how to have a layer here that floats and has a top-to-butt link like that. I had one on my previous site as well. I've been having some issues with WordPress. I don't know what happened, but I've decided that I'm done with WordPress. I'm sick of it. I'm going back to WYSIWYG. It's much easier for me to have WordPress being that I'm putting out a lot of content all the time. So when I publish my videos, it's easier for me to upload them into my WordPress and share them with you guys. But quite frankly, the security issues are a pain in the ass, and I'm tired of them. So I'm going back to WYSIWYG. So you're going to get a sneak peek at what I'm building right now. I've been working on it the past couple of days, and here we go. Here it is. So I got a lot of fancy stuff in here that I've been trying to show you guys a little bit with expanding layers and all kinds of stuff, rollover buttons I did a tutorial on one time, master frames I'm using. And what we're going to do now is add in our back to top button. So the first thing we want to do here is drop in a layer that's not going to move on me here. So let me see here. Grab the layer tool out of the advanced box here in the toolbox. And I'm going to drag out a size. I don't need it to be huge. Maybe I guess 70 by 70 is not terrible. And I'm going to set it off to the side here. And now what we want to do is make this a sticky layer. We're going to set it to the bottom right. And my offset is going to be, why don't we just for grins here make it negative 75 by negative 75, and that should, let me just make this a color so I can see it, and that should put it right in this area. Nope, okay, so that put it, okay, so maybe we do need to go positive 75. Let's see what that does. There it is. Okay, so now this layer is going to stick with us wherever we go. So now all we have to do is add a button with a link in there. It's going to take us to the top of the page. And I'm actually going to maybe drag it down a little bit less than 75. Maybe we'll go 30 pixels off for each. I'm going to get rid of this color, no border. Okay, perfect. So there's that. For the button, you can do any number of things. You can find an arrow on Google, or use a shape. I think I'm gonna use a shape because what I'm going for here is kind of like a nice, kind of minimalistic type design. So I'm not looking for a lot of fancy glossy things or shadows. I'm trying to get rid of most of that. So I just want kind of a simple arrow here. Use my theme color that I've been using. I'm going to get rid of the border and erase that puppy. I'll give it a hover mode so that we know that something's going to happen when we hover it. And that should be it. Now what I need to do is rotate her so that it's pointing up. Resize it. My size was 70 by 70, so I'm going to go 60 by 60 on the arrow here. And I'm going to drop it inside that layer. And it's a little bit obnoxious, so maybe we'll go 30 by 30 on that. Yeah, it's a little bit better. I'm thinking, sorry. Okay, so yeah, that's not bad. Okay, so now my event, I have a rollover event on it. So now what we're going to do is link this. I got to remember how to do this. So now what we need to do is add a bookmark. And you've probably seen these before. It's got like a little anchor on it. Some people call them anchor links. So we're just going to drop this up to the top of the page. I'm going to come outside my layer just because I'm not sure how that'll affect it. And I'm just going to rename this top. That way I know that I'm looking to the top of the page. I'm going to give it an ID of top because everything that I try to do on a master frame, I always try to give it a... I always try to give it a unique name so that way it doesn't conflict with other pages. So we'll just call this one top button. Now what we're going to do is just create a link. And we're going to do a smart link. Nope, I'm sorry. Internal page. You're going to, instead of selecting a page, you're going to bookmark, select your top. And that should be it, I think. So let's go over to my About page, which is nice and long. There's my top arrow. And I click that, and it takes me to the top. So, let's see what else we can do here. Bookmark, select, no. I thought I did this before. I gotta remember how I did it now. Where when I clicked on that thing, it just kind of scrolled to the top. Let me explore the events here. Is there a JavaScript function for this? Alert history search. Yeah, I can't remember how I did that. I'm going to have to go in and find it now. So let me create a new instance here. I know it was the way I did this before. So let me go into my old WYSIWYG site. Let me look at the top button I have here. And I did a rollover image. Okay, and I linked it to a bookmark. Is there a property in the bookmark? No. Maybe it was, oh, is it this? Okay. Ultimate page scroller properties. So I set the vertical, the speed. Okay, so it looks like I did that with an extension you need to download. It should be free. I've never paid for an extension. And it's called the Ultimate Page Scroller. So... according to that, I didn't do anything other than drop this in and went through a few settings. So the direction we want to be vertical, we're going to the top. Speed, and we'll just leave all that the same. So now let's check it out and see if this puppy scrolls. And there it goes. Okay, cool. So that's all you needed was that, that extension. Click on it and it scrolls up instead of just automatically loading it. So that's a pretty quick tutorial. There's a lot you can do to try and style your button. And then I guess real quick also, as far as loading it into place, you know, we have, I think it was on the layer, this delay. You can set that delay to zero so that it, you see that it's just always there. It doesn't move. So when I had that delay to 500, you saw it started off in the very center of the screen and then moved into place. And then you can set how fast it does that and whether or not it does that at all. And let me just go over the easing real quick on in this extension here. So I assume that the slower, the lower the number, the slower the speed, much like everything else. So let's knock that down by half, go to 500. I'm going to close out these other ones. All right, so do that. Yeah, so it goes a little bit faster. So if you want to speed that up, just lower your number down. And that's it. That's a sneak peek at my website. That's how to do a scrolling button to the top of the page. I definitely would say get that extension, because that's pretty cool. That's pretty professional. It looks a lot nicer. So if you got any questions for me, please visit my site. I got a contact form on the homepage right at the moment. It looks like this. Hopefully sometime in the next couple of days, we'll be going over to the actual site here, my new site. So I'll let you preview the homepage where we're at. It looks about the same. You know, it doesn't change much for me. Just kind of a new layout, new header. And let's open it. There we go. You'll probably recognize that from my one tutorial. And that's it. Alrighty. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. It makes me want to do more of these for you. If you got any questions, hit me up on my email or my website. And I'll catch you on the next episode.